Hi! In a previous video, I created this running spaceman. In this video, I give him a couple of guns and let him switch them by pressing a button. So, this is the previous project. Link to that video is in the description. What new here is a couple of weapon sprites. Pistol and shotgun. I bring them to the scene. There we go. Weapons are a little too big, so I scale them down. Okay. Shotgun and pistol will be carried about here. So, to give spaceman a weapon, I need to instantiate it. To instantiate a game object, I need a prefab of it. Prefabs will be loaded from resources folder. So, I create one in assets folder. It's very important not to make a typo in the folder's name. One mistake and it will not work. Folder is created and I drag and drop pistol and shotgun game objects into it, making them prefabs. I can delete these game objects from hierarchy. To instantiate a weapon, to give it a correct position and other stuff, I use a script. Here it is. Boring variables here. Fun begins in update method. If Q button is pressed, then the switch weapon method is invoked that consists of more fun. Here I check a value of which weapon selected variable. If it's 1, then it means that a pistol will be spawned. But first I have to remove a weapon if it's already in the character's hand. When it's done, a new weapon is instantiated, which is a pistol in this case. Pistol prefab is loaded from prefabs subfolder of resources folder. In fact, I forgot to create that prefabs folder, so I'm going to get an error later. But I'll fix it. I promise. Okay. After instantiation, I make this weapon to be a child of a character, so it follows the player wherever he goes. Then I set a local position of a pistol, so it appears in the character's hand. Well, kind of. Next line is about to give a weapon a higher value of order and layer option, so it's rendered in front of the character's sprite. Then I reset weapon's local scale, so it faces outwards the player. Last line increases which weapon selected value, so next weapon will be selected when Q button is pressed one more time. All the same stuff happens in case if which weapon selected equals to 2. Difference is in shotgun instantiation, of course. Pistol is removed, shotgun is in hands. The last thing here is that if which weapon selected exceeds the number of guns, then it's set back to 1. So it's kind of weapon selection cycle. That's the script. Drag and drop this script to character. I already did that. Now I hit play and show you how to get errors, because, as I said before, I forgot to put my weapon's prefabs into prefabs subfolder. I press Q and error appears. I fixed that by creating prefabs subfolder in resources folder and putting pistol and shotgun prefabs into it. There we go. Now it should work fine. And it does. I can switch a weapon pressing Q button. I hope you liked this tutorial, thank you for watching and see you next time.